We're talking about remote working, social distancing, isolations, things that we have not heard for a long time. What are the skills that are going to be critical from now on from an HR's point of view? In terms of, we used to talk, you know, the age-old skills of communication and collaboration, and for a decade we have been talking about all this. Now it seems like it's, you know, changing into, you know, self-isolation and all these new terms and jargons that are coming in. How important is it for an organization, business? And in terms of a recruitment perspective, what are the new skills that you're going to look for when recruiting engineers?
Okay, so I actually think collaboration, communication, everything you mentioned still is much needed. Only thing is how you actually make it effective in collaboration, in communication might take a different turn because you're going to have to use technology, you're going to have to use a different set of maybe applications and tools compared to before. So in that sense of, okay, if I just start from where we are right now and maybe before we get to post COVID, I think we are kind of going to go through an element of, you know, right now we are all in isolation. We are all kind of, our introvertness, our paranoia is coming up a little bit more than intended. And I think it will take a little while to adjust back to when things become somewhat normal. But I think being able to adapt, that resilience of changing and focus becomes important. To talk about, to answer your question about the isolation, etc., I think a way I would describe it is each one of us sort of becomes a little bit of an island, but we have to be able to maneuver and manage on that island to be able to deal with the rest of the world. If I am, for example, if it's a tech person, if it is creating, you know, coming up with new ideas, etc., you will have to engage with others to brainstorm, come up with those ideas. Then you will need that space to be able to innovate, create, get your thinking going. Then you would need to be able to figure out how you demo these things, sell these things. So I think the same value chain, but the whole chain of what needs to happen will continue, but self, a lot more critical, because most of us in our offices, part of HR and part of management was to try and give that structure. It's a little bit harder to give that structure when everybody is somewhat isolated. So how we can encourage and empower people to be able to structure their own lives and be able to kind of, you know, step up when need be able to deal with difficulties, mental awareness in terms of knowing how to deal with it when you do get moody, you will have more mood swings. So I feel that that is the area that you kind of need to uplift a little bit. So from an HR perspective, how we can actually help people be more self-aware, be able to manage. You can't switch people on and off. Sometimes we think we can, but we can't. So I feel people will have to be empowered to be able to know to ask for space when they need to take a break. I know, Hugo, I heard you say need for speed, but at the same time, if we don't help our people know when to switch off so that they're there for the longer haul, I think we're going to lose. So, you know, helping people.
I'm going to pause you on that, Barney. I'm going to pause you on that note, because okay, since you mentioned Hugo, now it's, I'm just going to ask Hugo this. And sourcing top talent, especially, you know, in a remote first culture, and Barney's talking about all these, you know, collaboration and all that stuff. What are the characteristics that's going to help developers now reach the next level, especially in a remote first culture?
Yeah, good question. Yeah, thanks for your comment also, Barney. I also, of course, completely agree. It's not only work. And I think that also, trying to make people very much aware on how this balance between work and life should be implemented, especially during these times, right? When everything flows together and people are working from home and the families everywhere, basically, and work as well. I think that that's a really big challenge. So thanks for that comment. And also, I also want to make that nuance a little bit, because it's not like we want people to work 24/7. I think that's not good for anyone. And having people, having them healthy and happy is, of course, what we want to achieve in the end. Coming back to your question, Jonathan, I think that if you look at, particularly what type of skills that people should now be looking at, I think it is, I think it's really, like I said in the beginning, right? So I think that there are certain trends that they have to take into account. But I think it's also, it really depends, of course, on the type of organization that you're now might want to work for. I think that if you look at, for example, the client base of Capstars, is we work for fast-growing tech scale-ups. Most of them are VC funded, basically meaning they have external venture capitalists backing them up. And that also means that they have a certain amount of money and a roadmap, and that they are going to burn through that money as fast as possible and then get output also as fast as possible in order to dominate their respective markets, right? So that is the business dynamic that they're in. And I think that what you're going to see right now is that if you look at these type of businesses, the budget is going to be even more constrained, right? Because there's going to be less money in the market in order to pump these companies. But probably the demand for innovative and creative services is going to be even stronger, right? So you have less money and you want to do more with the money you have, basically. So I think that right now, the advantages for these type of companies is that remote developers are going to be a better option, right? Because like we discussed earlier, on-site is no longer necessarily a benefit. So I think that if you look at the remote workers, they don't have to compete with on-site developers anymore. So that comes with a cost advantage for companies. So I do expect them to look more and more to offshore development places. So that, I think, is one thing. And then I think if you look at how developers should then act. So like I said, it's really a matter of having less money and more a critical time to market, which basically means that product and engineering are going to be converging even more, right? So you're going to see that product and engineering departments are going to be working together really closely in order to make sure that the margin when it comes to getting your software to the market, so your time to market, technical glitches, or even components that do not have a direct return on investment, they will be basically on the lookout for these type of errors, and that they want to avoid this, right? So as a developer, my advice would be read up on the same knowledge as your product owner or product manager, and basically try to understand how and why certain features are prioritized, right? So Bani, once again, this is very technical. Maybe you also have some things to say on this. But for me, just to give you an example, like one of our clients, for example, they are going really, really far in installing these type of measures. I'm sure that most of the listeners are familiar with KPIs or OKRs, which are basically a set of values explaining like, hey, how good are you doing, right? So you can do this for sales, you can do this for marketing, but you can also do it for development. And I think right now there's already a new trend where they are also looking at developers installing OKRs on the components that are being built by these developers, attached to the revenue generated and or the costs saved by the components that they have built or that they are building, right? So these developers have now a direct impact on the value of the product and the profitability of the company. So I think that, if you look at this, like companies are becoming much, much smarter. And I think that as developers, we are, of course, used to be very analytical and to work with numbers and to understand all these types of dynamics. So we have a big advantage there. But I think that, looking at the skill set needed for remote developers, which we are now, all of us, right? Doesn't matter where you are, is really to understand this dynamic, to be able to act in a business value first environment, and then to show to your peers, not only your colleague engineers, but also to your product owners, hey, I understand what I'm doing. Hey, I understand why I'm building this. And I understand what is going to be the part of this piece of software that is going to actually make money for the company, right? So I think that that's really where you can actually stand out now. And I think if you understand that, I think that there's, like I said before, a bright future for people that have that mindset.